So I don't know if some of you younger listeners may not remember, but we used to shoot on this thing called film and we used to not have Photoshop. And, you know, it used to be a lot different. Like there wasn't really any retouching. So when the girl had issues or, you know, bruises or whatever, that was something that you had to fix in camera. It wasn't something that you could fix in post. And that was something that you taught me very much. And I'm still true to this day. Like I really try to get things perfect in camera. I feel like this generation of photographers now with the technology and Photoshop and iPhones and all that kind of stuff, people just shoot whatever and then they fix it later, you know? And I feel like that's kind of taken some of the artistry out of photography, which has been kind of frustrating for me because I was taught very much about getting it right in camera on set at that time, not necessarily fucking with it later. So
draping it.
Yeah. My mom is very famous for her draping and her blue silks. And if you look at back at any of her old photos, you'll see a lot of like, especially if it's a bedroom set, there'll be like sheets kind of draping off the edge of the bed and like kind of spilling onto the floor. And it's very like, it's draping, very Suze Randall.
Draping over creases in the waist.
Right. Exactly. Like using like wardrobe to hide like, you know, certain body flaws, stuff like that. So. It's
but it's time consuming. I mean, the old days, they used to shoot a penthouse layout in one day.
Or more than that, right?
No, I spent 3 days doing a penthouse layout, centerfold.
I mean, 3 days. But these days, you're lucky if you get one day.
Yeah, I mean, one day, and not only do you have to shoot the entire centerfold, but you have to shoot all the video that goes along with it, maybe an interview, something like that. It's just like... It's crazy. It's crazy how much it's changed. So, yeah, I mean, that's a big difference between, you know, today and back in my parents' day. You know, they really had a lot of time to spend on shooting the pictures. And it was really just about photos then. And now it's just about video. And photos are kind of like second, which is, you know, which is hard for me because at my heart, I'm still very much a photographer. And I shoot video and I like shooting video. But, you know, photography is my first love, but there's just not that much of a market for it anymore. It's really like all about video these days, and photos just kind of like illustrate what happens in the video scene. So it's definitely been like a big shift there. And I know that
the photos are used to promote the video.
Exactly. Mm. Exactly.
And we were lucky because it was so frowned upon. It was not the sort of thing that you did, nudes, and that was shocking, and everybody wanted it. And now everybody does it, and it's like, oh, you know, everybody's got plastic surgery, and everybody's got this and that, and yeah. It's not the same. It was great to have a band be doing something that was not approved of.
I know you love doing things that are not approved of,
yeah,
Mom.
Yeah.
Well, not approved of and all the way to illegal.
Yeah.
I mean, you guys had like the Vice Squad, like going through your trash and stuff like that, right? I mean, tell me a little bit about shooting porn back when it was legal, back before the Freeman case, which is actually a case that legalized pornography in California specifically. So tell us a little bit about that, you know, back when you guys were renegades.
What the authorities were doing was using the pimping and pandering statutes to apply to pornography. So the Friedman case you refer to was he appealed being convicted as a pimp for taking nude pictures.
Right.
And that was appealed all the way to the California Supreme Court. And they threw it out. So they ruled in his favor.
Right.
And ever since then, it's legal. But it used to be really scary when it's illegal because the pimping and battering penalties were extreme. Minimum 3 years in jail.
Wow. And this is, what year is this?
This is about the late 80s.
Okay, so I was alive then. I had been born.
Yeah.
So yes. You guys were worried about possibly going to jail and leaving your daughter at home.
It wasn't that word. I mean, the Vice kept trying to get things against us, but nobody would speak against us. We didn't do anything wrong. We did, you know, we did our best for everybody. We had Stephen Yagman, who was our a friend attorney who wanted to make some money out of this, and he dragged me down to the court case.
Courthouse,
where they were trying Jim South, I think, on this pimping and pandering thing.
For those of you who don't know, Jim South was like the big talent agency back in the day. I mean, honestly, he was the only talent agent. Like, he had Jenna Jameson. Like, he was the only guy. And he's still in business now, but he doesn't get the quality of girls that he used to. And there's a lot of agencies nowadays. But back in the day, Jim South was the guy. So go on.
So, yeah, this friend, in quotes, lawyer introduced me to the vice squad and
in the courthouse.
What did I call them? Shoeshine boys.
The lawyer was trying to drum up a court case.
Yeah.
You imagine that?
Okay, so he was trying to use mom as like
a bait.
Bait to get them pissy enough.
He wanted the cops to bust her so he could defend her.
He wanted the cops to bust her.
Yes.
So, yeah. And he knew how kind of like how you are.
I don't think he knew I was that bad, but...
He knew that you might start a fight. I think he suspected
hoping.
That. And you did.
Yes, I did.
Of course you did.
And so they used to go through our trash and look for stuff and interview all the models, but they couldn't get anything against us, and we paid our taxes and we did all the right things. You know, as long as you don't mess with the tax man, you're fine.
Yeah, I know. That's the one thing you guys always told me, like, don't fuck with the IRS. Just pay your taxes and everything else will be okay. I'm like,
There's a downside to the liberalization of porn is that now everybody and his grandmother does it.
Yeah.
And that's what I was saying earlier. Yeah. It's really hard.
Yeah, and it's free everywhere and so no one pays for it.
The technology is so different to the old film, which used to be a real slap to do.
Yeah, so you guys shot some movies back in the 70s, and you shot that on film, right, Dad?
Yes, 16mm.
16mm, and that was back when you actually had to cut the film, right, to, like, make the edits. Like, you literally cut the film. It's crazy to think about that now.
I cut the film, I hung them up in bins.
Yeah. I mean, that's so old school. It's incredible.
Imagine. What a sweat it was.
Yeah. I remember you guys, because, you know, mom was always very much a photographer, but you guys did shoot some movies, like I said, but I remember you always telling me, like, oh, God, shooting movies is like going to war.
I didn't like it.
It's just like so much work.
You've got to be quiet. That's the trouble.
Yeah, it's hard for you.
I can't do that. I like to be the cheerleader. You know, come on, deeper, faster, harder.
When we started shooting video for Suze.net, we used to have to throw my mom out of the studio because she'd be standing there smoking a cigarette, watching the monitor with the two people having sex, and she'd like start doing this kind of weird hip rocking thing that was really kind of awkward, and then she'd like start commenting like, oh yeah, baby, let's mop this. Yes, yes, yes. I'm like, mom, shut up. We're filming sound. So like we literally had to throw her out and like not have her there when we shot video because she just couldn't keep her mouth shut.
No, it's very hard.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, make sure that you subscribe so you don't miss a single episode. And go check out all the other videos. I film every single one of my podcasts. And if you want to listen to the audio version, I'm on iTunes and all the other podcast platforms. Visit hollyrandallunfiltered.com to find out more.